Hey guys, how are you doing? I'm Anime Intensity, welcome back to my channel. So this past Wednesday, I actually had the honor of going to see this awesome anime film in theaters. It's called The Night is Short, Walk on Girl, and it's by Masaki Yuasa, who actually has worked on Devilman Crybaby, and also things like Lou Over the Wall, which is very, very crazy. If you've seen any of Masaki Yuasa's films, sometimes you're very, very trippy. So just a lot of things going on. It's very eccentric. It's very out there. And this film is definitely no exception. If I had to describe it in one word, it's definitely, definitely trippy. But I say that in a good way. I'm not saying that in a bad way. It's just, it's so colorful. There's so many things on the screen at the same time. There's so many, the way like the story is told, it's so out there, so different. And honestly, that's what makes Night is Short, Walk on Girl so, so great, is because it has so many things going on for it. And I really have to admit, like, I know I heard like this is supposed to be like a companion to the Tatami Galaxy. I have never finished the Tatami Galaxy, mainly because when I did give it a shot, I was totally confused. I was like, whoa, all I remember is this onion kid. But aside from that, I really was confused when I was watching the Tatami Galaxy. Maybe it's because the dialogue was too fast. Maybe, I don't know. It was just a lot of information to process. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to put this on hold. I'm going to come back to it. But right now, I'm really lost. So this movie actually made me want to go back to the Tatami Galaxy, because seeing how they're supposed to be connected, I was like, okay, I absolutely loved this anime film. That means I'm probably going to enjoy the Tatami Galaxy. I just really need to sit down, focus, pay attention while I watch it, and hopefully I'll be able to follow everything that's going on. Night is Short, Walk on Girl definitely has a lot more than what you see on the surface. Like, what you see on the surface is like crazy things. A lot of things that you're like, huh? Like, this is crazy. Even when they're eating, what they eat is so huge, and you're like, that's not real. And a lot of the things that you see look very like supernatural. Like, this doesn't happen in real life. But I think that Masaki Yuasa did all of this for a reason. I think that the story is like that for a reason, because it's trying to tell a story, but is using very crazy ways to convey it. It's hard to explain, but there's so many like metaphors, there's imagery used in it. I feel like this anime film could be really analyzed because there is so much going on than what we just see, which we see like that, those bright colors, the great animation, the crazy things going on. There's a lot of things that make you want to laugh, or like you're just kind of confused. You're kind of like, huh? But I think that's all done for a reason, because it's not just about the story. It's not just about telling a simple story. It's about telling a story by using all of these methods to make it so beautiful and so different. And I think that's what makes Night is Short, Walk on Girl so, so special. And if this is anything like what the Tatami Galaxy is like, I am going to absolutely adore this series. I honestly wasn't too sure if I was going to like Night is Short, Walk on Girl, mainly because when I got into the theater, the movie had already started, and it maybe like only a minute or two but had passed. But the thing is, like, I was already confused. I was like, oh no. Like, sometimes when I go see Masaki Yuasa films, I'm like, okay, I don't really know what's going on. So I was like really confused. But then when you actually learn about the story, about this girl who just wants to find that book from her childhood that she absolutely loved, and then you have the senpai who's in love with the girl who wants the book, and you see this traveling theater who always gets in trouble and with their futon and everything, is or their kotatsu or whatever, it's really so much more of a story than that. I really like how they expressed time, like how this all was just one night, but it felt like it was so long. And how the, you know, it was summer, and then everyone got sick at one point, and the weather turned cold. It was cold, and you know, our main character had to wear like gloves and a hat because it was just freezing outside. So I think that, you know, for in that case, it wasn't because it was actually cold outside. I think that since people had actual colds, since they were sick, that's how it was displayed. The night was cold because they were actually having colds. So I like the use of things like that. I like the way concepts were displayed, ideas were displayed. And I really think that this film is something different. I found it to be very enjoyable. I found many moments to be funny, especially that traveling theater troupe thing going on. I thought they were hilarious, and they probably had some of the best musical numbers that I have seen in anime ever. So I really had to appreciate that. I really loved our characters and the whole love story. And while the movie isn't like too romantic or anything, it's just nice to see our senpai try to win over this girl and do some crazy things and then end up getting sick and waiting for her. It was just nice to see all of that. And I gotta admit, I love the way the art was. Thought there were a bunch of bright colors. Animation was great. It was stunning. It was good. And honestly, like, while this film is definitely eccentric in its own way, I gotta say, I really, really enjoyed it. So I hope you guys go check out Night Is Short, Walk On Girl for yourselves. I definitely recommend it. If you watched it already, feel free to comment below and let me know how you felt about the film. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. So I appreciate it. Feel free to like, share, comment, or subscribe if you'd like this video, and I will see you guys next time.